Hey, Jill. Oh, I can't hear you.
There, I unmuted myself.
Hello, how are you?
I'm good.
I have never ever got to meet you like face to face, so hey.
I know, it seems like we've been like crossing paths a little on like Facebook. That, right? But.
Yeah. It was kind of fun on our Emerald call the other night to meet a bunch of people from y'all and Megan's team too. So
Yeah, it sounded like that was a really good call.
It went really well. I think it was beneficial for everybody. So
yeah.
I think we'll do it again next month with whatever Emeralds want to hop on. So
yeah, I love that idea.
I know that call that Emma did for us was like gold for me.
Gosh.
I just opened my eyes to a lot of stuff. So
I totally can relate to her and like a lot of like what she does and how she, you know, handles things. And
yes,
I really like that.
Agree. Well, I know there were several people that said they're going to be late hopping on or they might be in and out. So I did remember, let's make sure real quick here, it is recording.
Yes, I saw that. I always forget to record ours. And
yes. Oh, there's somebody else. Okay. Well, I will go ahead and just get us started, and then whoever hops on, we'll keep going, and we'll post that recording later. So I'm glad to actually meet you, though. Okay, so tonight, our agenda, we're going to do welcome and prayer, announcements and recognition, and then we're going to be diving into the first night of the series that has been laid on my heart to share with our team. So we'll have part one of that, and then just question and answer, whatever you guys have for me. It's going to be rapid fire, whatever you want to ask. So we will go ahead and dive on in, and like I said, I'd like to open with a prayer for us. Lord, I thank you so much for each of the wonderful people on our team. I thank you for just the way that it has been growing, and people have been stepping up in leadership, and just all of the wonderful things that have been going on with our teams. I thank you for that, Lord, and I just pray that you would continue to use us to help transform people's lives in radical ways, and that tonight, the word that I feel you have given me to share, that you would use it to bless those that are able to listen tonight live and to those that will be listening to this recording. So please open our ears to hear tonight and just bless this time. In your name, amen.
Amen.
All right. Hey, there's a few more people.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So announcements. I am sure you guys saw me going crazy, all excited about the Summit Waitlist news that blew all of us away earlier this week. Anybody who was on the waitlist at that $195 price has been invited off at this point in time. So if you were unaware of that, get on, check your email, get your tickets. If you are one of the people that was like, I'm never going to get off the waitlist and didn't ever put yourself on it, go do it right now, because there, I mean, what are the chances they're going to open it up for the $200 tickets next? So get yourself on there. Also, I don't know if you guys saw me share the quote that was given by one of our uplines that I shared with our team yesterday, I believe. People that went to their first summit in 2014 saw their earning increase by 198% that following year. And I don't know about you guys, but just reading that blew my mind and made me even more excited. I was already so pumped to go for the first time. But I don't know. I mean, that just like blew my mind. So I can only imagine what we are all going to experience after we leave in July and we go into another exciting year with our businesses. So if you aren't on that wait list, get on it and make sure that you do everything you can to try to be there. If not this year, next year, make it a priority. I have somebody saying goodnight, I think.
Sorry. I love you. I tried to take her to bed without saying goodnight and she lost it.
Oh, I love you.
I love you, Mommy. Oh, do you want to say hi to all the people? Say hello, peoples.
Hi.
Goodnight.
Can you give Mommy your spray kisses? Okay. That's all right. Say night night, Mama.
I know. I love you.
Oh, bedtime fun.
It's not normally that bad. I don't know what's up. She's normally daddy's girl all the way.
Oh, that's too cute.
Okay, continuing on here. Something that I had forgotten to share about on our last call was the announcement that they made about the 2018 Success Club trip. And you guys are probably thinking, like, 2018, why are you talking about that right now? Well, it really matters for right now because right now is the time that you're qualifying for that trip. So I wanted to make sure you understood the new requirements for being able to be a part of that trip. I don't know about you, but the trips really excite me. I know from our team, Megan got to go on the cruise this last go and said it was amazing, so wonderful. And there's several of us that are going to be on the 2017 trip and looking forward to that. So definitely set your sights on this Success Club trip. This is how you can be a part of it. The registration window will be opening in January of 2017, so less than a year from now. And it will be first opened up. It's going to be opened up in waves. So the first wave will be for Elite, Premier, and SC Legends. Those are the people that have had 24 consecutive months with Success Club. They will be able to sign up first. Second wave will be for the paid five-star coaches, SC All-Stars. That would be people who have had Success Club for 12 consecutive months. And then beyond that, the top 100 2016 Success Starters. So that applies to several people on our team that are working for Success Starters right now. And then the final wave will be for general registration. And you will be invited to register based off of your Success Club point earned in 2016. So it's going to go from the people that earned from the top down. So if you want to go on this trip, you need to make these things and Success Club a priority for you. I think that this is going to be a little bit more fair than it has been in the past for people that have wanted to go on these trips. And you know, it's called the Success Club trip for a reason. So I think that a lot of people are excited about these qualifications. But you need to know now that in order to make it to that trip, you need to be earning Success Club now, okay? So I want to make sure you guys are aware of that. Next thing, I am wanting to start within our team calls a four vital behaviors focus, okay? So you probably saw me share in our team yesterday a quote that really stood out to me and that's now going to be my mantra for the next little while here. You're better to do essential things, like our vital behaviors, every day than big things on some days. And that's from John Maxwell, an incredible leadership teacher, book author, just a wonderful resource. And I really, really like that. I'm somebody, as you guys know, that likes to like plan every tea out in my life, and sometimes I get the big picture confused with little tasks that I feel like I have to get taken off of my to-do list. And so I think for all of us, that's a wonderful reminder to do those vital behaviors every single day. And the big things, you know, if you can get your vital behaviors done, then go on and focus, if you have extra time, on whatever those other tasks are that are on your to-do list for your business. But don't forget, don't negate those essential things that you have to do every single day. And so, with that in mind, I'm going to be offering a prize after every team call that we have. One person, whoever just speaks up first on our call, one person who can list off those four vital behaviors for us and share how you have been doing them recently. So I won't put you on the spot tonight, but know that next team call, I will allow whoever wants to step up, list those off for us, and share how you have been doing those within your business over the 2-week period of time since this call, okay? So be looking forward to that. Okay, recognition. Right now, we have tonight, tomorrow, and Saturday until 10 p.m. to lock in our Success Club for this month. And currently on the board for our team, we have Brooke Blake with 8, Megan has 6, Annie has 6, Tiffany 6, Melissa 4, Trina 2, Alyssa 2, Shelly 2, Lois 2, and Shannon Kuhlman has 2. So awesome job to you guys. I know it has been a challenging month for many people on our team. That's why I'm doing this series. I want to help remind you that you can do this. But I just wanted to congratulate those of you that are on that Success Club board at this point. And don't give up. You guys still have a few more days to go. I know I haven't come close to my goal yet, and I'm still pushing. I'm believing I can get there. So don't give up. Last 3 days here. Okay, recognition, personal health journey. Someone on our team, I don't even know, I can't see all of you guys, if Melissa's on here or not. Not yet. I don't know if you guys have seen. Melissa has been doing 21-day fix now for 5 weeks. She's been on our team for 5 weeks. And I just wanted to give a team shout out to her. This is 5 weeks ago, and then she took these pictures on Tuesday. And I am blown away by her 5-week results with that program. She is super excited. She's feeling better, most of all. That's what's most important to her. She feels better. Her family is getting on board. She's really excited for that. And I think for the first time in a very, very long time, she's making herself a priority in the midst of all that she does as a busy mom. And I just wanted to give her a shout out on our call. So way to go, Melissa. Also, I wanted to give a shout out to Shannon Kuhlman. I got to meet her on our Emerald call the other night, and I found out that she just recently hit Emerald. She also is a very shy personality, and she has been putting herself out there daily and sharing her story, and that has been terribly scary for her. And I just wanted to commend her for stepping out there, sharing her journey, and then also showing up and being on that call for the first time on Monday night. I'm sure it was way out of her comfort zone, but she took the time to learn something about this business that she didn't know before. And so all of those things, her rank advancement, sharing her journey, even when it's scary, putting herself out there and learning the business, getting on that call, even though it was probably way out of her comfort zone. So I just wanted to say, I'm so happy you are here, Shannon, and congratulations to you. Also, in our Team Heart page, I have noticed just in the last several weeks that Jocelyn and Alyssa have been these awesome cheerleaders on our page. I noticed that they're the first people when somebody shares something exciting, they like, they comment, they cheer people on their personal profiles too, when they put posts out that are kind of scary for them out of their comfort zones. I've noticed that these two are wonderful about just being that encouraging and positive cheerleader role for our team. And so I wanted to thank you guys for that. That's definitely the kind of atmosphere that I want us to have. So thank you, ladies. Also, Shannon Kohlmeyer has joined our team just last week, and she's in a challenge group again right now. She's been journeying on her health journey now for, goodness, it's probably close to a year. She's been in and out of challenge groups, and but she just dove in as a coach for the first time, and she has the day that she dove in as a coach, she ordered several personal development books and has already dove into reading them and is already feeling that impact of mentally feeding yourself, you know, that we, those of us that have dove into personal development, how enriching and rewarding that is. And it's typically the one that new coaches kind of put off to the side for a while. I know I didn't read personal development probably for my first 9 months. So don't follow in my footsteps. But I just wanted to tell her awesome job for stepping in and diving right in and knowing that that mental clarity, that piece of the coaching and health journey is just as important as all of those other ones. So way to go, Shannon. All right. So that is all the recognition for tonight. I want to go ahead and dive on into our training. So if you were not able to be on our intro call a few weeks back, I just wanted to give you a little kind of recap of why I am doing this training. It's a little bit different than anything I've ever trained on. It's not totally business focused. Like, it's not like, this is how you do this. This is how you hit Success Club. This is how you hit Emerald and Rank Advance. It's not one of those trainings. For me, this shares very much with you guys a big piece of who I am and my heart to a T, and addresses something that I feel has been part of what has been pulling a lot of our spirit down within our team. Just recently, I've noticed that there's been a lot of just, I don't know how to say it best. I just feel like we're not all mentally in a good place. And mentally, spiritually, emotionally, I feel like a lot of us are really struggling through some personal things right now. And I'm not quite sure what that is for you. I know for me, it has been dealing and working through all of my postpartum anxiety, depression stuff. It has been challenging for a while, but just as of late, it's been really hard for me. And so I've been very, very, very heavily diving into personal development. And for me, there's a tremendous spiritual side to that. So I've been spending a lot of time in prayer and in the Bible. And I came across the book Made to Crave that I know Megan and Jill, your teams, have used that book like crazy. And it was a great recommendation for me. I have fallen in love with that book, and I shared last week that it is a book that fits our challenge groups really, really, really well. I love incorporating it there, talking about satisfying your deepest desire with God and not with food. But I personally, probably because of the things I've been going through, I have seen many parallels within it to the struggles with confidence that we have within our business. I see lots of parallels to how we can handle and deal with our businesses, how we can, get trapped in our own whatever struggles that we have with working this business. And so I saw it from that food side, and then I also have seen many things that I feel like can really help us as coaches on the business side of things. So that is why I'm using this book to help with our training. And I'm going to be really focusing on chapter 5 within the book. And it's the chapter that is called Made for More, hence our series being called You Are More. In the beginning of that chapter, it talks about there typically being a honeymoon phase at the start of any of our healthy eating plans or our healthy living ventures. Nothing tempts you away. You know, you're just 100% all in. We see our challengers experience that we go through those phases when we're going all in again. We all deal with those times of just being so pumped. Nothing's going to set us off track. And I think that for many of us, that's what it was like when we dove into this business too. You know, we were so excited. Personally, myself, I started in May of 2014, and I was so excited. I signed up the last day of school. I was a teacher at the time, and I signed up. I was like, yes, school's out. I can 100% go on this. And I spent that whole entire summer just like slamming everything that I could into this business, and was so on fire, so excited to help every person that I possibly could, share my story. You know, I just dove in. I did a lot of dumb things. I did a lot of good things. You know, we all do stupid stuff in the beginning. You look back and you kind of laugh at yourself. But I was definitely in that honeymoon phase of like, nothing's going to stop me. I'm going to rock this business. And then we hit those times where maybe it's not like that. You know, you come off of that honeymoon phase, you start kind of coasting in, getting into your norm with this, and then start coming the struggles of the business. And even though, like for me, I love this job so much. I can't believe I get to call it my job. So there's nothing in me that doesn't want to continue doing this. But there are times that my mind gets in the way of being comfortable sharing my story, of being the positive coach that I need to be for my challengers. You know, the personal health journey side of it. There's times where we aren't all in on that ourselves, right? So we all have those bumps in the road that we hit, just like we do in our health journeys within this business. And the fundamental truth that she teaches us in this chapter of the book is this quote right here. It says, "We were made for victory. Sometimes," oh, I spelled that wrong. "Sometimes we just have to find our way to that truth." And I love that. I really, really love how she says that, because I think that oftentimes we forget that we are made for more than the things that we are dealing with or that we're struggling through, that we already can claim victory over those things just because of who God has made us to be. And so finding our winding way to that truth, it's not something that you find it and then everything's all better. I feel like that road in our faith journey and in our life journey is constantly winding and constantly up and down, and we hit bumps in the road all the time. But remembering that that is a fundamental spiritual truth will help us through every aspect of our struggles within our health journeys and within our businesses. Okay, so that truth, we are made for more. I don't know about you guys, but this chapter in the book talks about go-to scripts that we have that play in our minds. And for me, it's not often that truth. I would love for that to be my go-to script, and it's something that I'm working on constantly. Especially right now, I'm really, really working to fix that. But my go-to scripts, whatever yours are, they may not be the same as mine. I shared about it today. I am a self-sabotager. I let my mind go to places that it should not go, especially now that I'm dealing with the sticky areas of anxiety and all that that entails. My mind is a very, very rough place at times, and it's crazy to think that within yourself you can have some of your hardest battles. But those go-to scripts, I will constantly find myself, without even realizing it, thinking something negative that just self-sabotages, and then I'll get hung up on it, and I will realize, like all of a sudden realize, where did that come from? Why am I thinking that? within our, you know, within our business, sending out messages. I know that some of you have shared with me, when you sit down to send out invites, okay, do you ever have your mind start working against you in that moment? Like where you are like, oh my gosh, I'm going to make somebody so mad by sending this message. You know, they're going to unfriend me. They're going to hate me. They're never going to want to see me in real life again. You know, like especially the business invites, that for me was a hard one to get over for a long time. And I know for some of you, it is as well. You just worry about what they're going to think about you. You worry about what the reaction is going to be. We just get so caught up in that stuff sometimes. And for me, those go-to scripts aren't always self-affirming and positive and full of that truth. So what I want us to really focus on doing, and what I have been personally focusing on doing, is rewriting whatever those go-to scripts are, whatever those things that are in your mind. When you face those challenges, I want you to really work on rewriting those scripts with the truth that you are made for more and that you have great things to offer to people, okay? Beyond Beachbody. We have wonderful resources. We can help people in so many ways. But you yourself, the person that you are, the coaching that you have to offer people, you have so much within you that many people need. And that's the truth that we need to have going through our minds when we're messaging people and when we're reaching out and when we're actually coaching within our challenge groups and within our teams. So I want to challenge you guys with that, rewriting those go-to scripts. There is wisdom and revelation within that truth that unlocks power available to all of us. And I'm going to say that one more time. I really want you to think about that. There is wisdom and revelation within that truth that unlocks power available to all of us. We all feel weak at times, right? Those moments when you're like, I don't want to do this. I don't like this part. I know they tell me to close my eyes and post, or they tell me to close my eyes and send the message. You know, you don't feel very strong in those moments, right? I know I don't, or I didn't before I got used to it. But there is wisdom and revelation within the truth that you are more and that you have wonderful things to offer people. You can unlock that power available to you by leaning on that truth more than you do your former go-to scripts. So the scripture that she uses to base this wisdom, revelation, and power thing off of is from Ephesians 1, 17 through 19. And that's what we're going to be breaking down this week, next call, and the one after that. So I'm going to read that to you, and then I'm going to tell you the sections that we're going to be looking at tonight and what they have to offer for us. I keep asking that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Father, may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation so that you may know him better. I pray also that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which he has called you, the riches of his glorious inheritance in the saints, and his incomparably great power for us who believe. So, I love that scripture. I love the reminder. It's actually from the Apostle Paul. It's a prayer that he prays, and I think very much applies to us where we are at this point in our lives and in our businesses as well. So I want us to focus on the very, very beginning of that. It says, I keep asking. That's where our first section is going to come from tonight. It says, I keep asking. And so to me, when you keep asking, you're being persistent, okay? And within the book, she's talking about being persistent and asking God to help you with your health journey, to help you with clean eating, that kind of stuff. I think for us as business owners that this is incredibly important for us as well to apply to our businesses, and something that has unlocked that door of power for me personally within my business, making my faith a big key player in what I do every day, praying before I start doing anything with my business, making sure that I know what is going on with people on my team and keep them in my prayers, knowing what's going on with my challengers, keeping them in my prayers. That kind of stuff to me has just really opened that door of power and helping me to feel that I'm not in this alone. I'm not relying on my own strength to do these things because I have been called to do this. And so that first point there, we must ask God to join us on this journey. And it's not just a one-time thing. Like right now, tonight, you're like, God, I want you to help me with my business. Okay, we got that out of the way. It's something that Paul did over and over and over again, where this scripture came from. Paul asked constantly for wisdom to help him through his incredible journey. And I think that that is something that we can learn from, and that for me personally has been very important within my business, praying on a daily basis, every single day, that in all that I do, that I would be aligned to the call that I feel he's given me with this business, and in what I feel is ministering to the women on my team and to the people in my challenge groups. And so I encourage you guys to be persistent in your prayer and in asking God to guide your business and help guide your steps when you're reaching out to people. And like I said, Paul doesn't ask for that wisdom one time. He asks for it over and over and over and over again. So I know for myself personally, like with my anxiety struggles, if I skip that, which I have, if I skip that step and I'll get into the middle of messaging and all of a sudden I'll realize in the middle of inviting or following up, I am feeling that just, I guess the best way I can describe my anxiety things is I just feel like I get really, 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 really heavy up to my chin, and all of a sudden I'm not breathing well. And that happens to me sometimes when I'm in the middle of doing my power hour stuff. And I will realize a lot of times that I didn't stop to pray before I started. I just got busy and dove right on in. And the moments, the days that I consistently pray for peace and for help and for guidance to the right people, the right things to say to help encourage people on their journeys, on those days, I feel so much more at ease and just comforted that I'm doing this for the right reason, and that I am not walking this journey alone. So I want to encourage you guys. She has a prayer within this chapter in the book for helping people to be persistent in asking God for help in their health journeys. And so I've changed the words of it a little bit to be able to help each of us with the struggles that we have within our businesses. And so the prayer that I have here, you are welcome to take it, use it, change it to be whatever you want. But I encourage you to pray daily before you do the things that you do within your business, and whether it be first thing in the morning, before you sit down at your computer. This is a prayer I would love for you to say. God, I recognize that I am made for more than the vicious cycles of being ruled by excuses, rationalizations, escape clauses, negative self-talk, or fill in the blank there, whatever it is for you that holds you back within your business. So I keep asking for your wisdom to know what to do with my business, and your indwelling power to walk away from and not listen to the things that derail me from impacting lives through this gift and calling of coaching. I think that prayer, if you prayed that every day before you began what you are supposed to be doing every day, those essential things, I would almost bet that you would feel better about doing those essential things every day. You would feel more confident. You would feel more peace. Because I know from my personal experience that I do. So I encourage you guys to write that down. I will be sharing these slides later if you want to look back at it, or just come up with your own, whatever words work for you to help you say out loud every day that you know that God has made you to be more than whatever struggle you have. And ask for his wisdom to help you and to give you power to find the people that need your help every day. And then I'm throwing in a little reminder here from my other favorite book, The Compound Effect. When we think of being persistent, I love the analogy that Darren Hardy gives in The Compound Effect of the pump well. It is not, you know, you can visualize the pump well. I know for me, I'm not a farm girl, but I went to the Sedgwick County Zoo a million times, and they have that little pump well area, right, in the middle of the farm. And you can go up to it, and I've always watched those kids when we go there with our elementary kids, go up and try to like pump, 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 pump really fast, and you'd watch them give up and walk off. Oh, this thing's broken. And I know, I'm sure you guys know this analogy, but I want to remind you of it. It takes lifting up that lever, pumping slowly and consistently, constantly, before you begin to even get a trickle of water out of that pump well. And then if you give up and you stop at that point, it all goes back down and you'd have to start the process all over again to get a trickle. But if you continue doing those, that pumping just over and over and over again, simply, slowly, consistently, those essential things that we have to do every day, right? Eventually that trickle that starts to come out will start to really flow, and you will have, before you know it, tons of water flowing out of that pump well. And then you can even at that point kind of loosen or let up on your pumping. You can even slow down a little bit more at that point. But you still must continually keep pumping for there to be water coming out at that level. And I just love that analogy for our businesses and for our spiritual journeys and for our healthy lifestyle journeys. All of those things can be compared to that pump well analogy, that we have to continually and consistently be doing those essential things on a daily basis that will get the results that we are hoping for, the blessings that will come from doing those things consistently. And so I would encourage you guys to make praying for your business, for your challengers, for your team, your future team if you don't have one, I would encourage you to make praying and being persistent in that a part of your daily essential tasks within your business. The next part of the scripture, it's a simple two words, glorious Father, is what she points out. And she attributes those two words to us embracing our true identities. And I'm pretty much gonna go verbatim from the book on this part, because I believe that we all need to hear this. And for me, I need to hear it like multiple times a week before I actually really get it. But the phrase glorious Father indicates our relationship to God. It answers the question, why are we made for more? For those of you that are like, okay, you're telling me I'm made for more, why would you ever say that to me? Why am I made for more? And the big answer there is that we have a glorious Father. And so that means that we are children of God. And I know for myself, like, it's one of those things that I know in my mind, but that I don't always fully embrace. And it's taken a long time. And it's still something that that identity piece, knowing who I am, has led me to having self-confidence issues at times. And I know that many of you struggle within your business sharing your journey, sharing your story, reaching out to people, because you are dealing with a lack of self-confidence. And so you're constantly asking for personal development books about how do I be a more confident person, right? I know I read all of those books. I'm always looking for that thing that's going to make it click for me. So I just get it, right? But the thing that I keep coming back to is that there's no personal development out there in the world that can tell me more truth than this right here. And I will still continue to read personal development books, just like I think you guys should. But I think that the ultimate truth is right here in what we're about to go over. So please don't ever forget this and go back to it again and again and again, just like praying. What I want you guys to think about is in the past or right now, if you're struggling with self-confidence right now, how are you identifying yourself? Okay, think through that. what kinds of things do you actually identify yourself as? I know for a while there, like it was, I'm Christy the teacher. That's what I was. That, you know, you identify yourself by your job, right? You identify yourself, many of us, as moms. But going even a little bit deeper than that, I'm going to share, I have it on there, on the screen for you guys, some of the things that I really deep down struggled with. And I challenge you guys to write out your own sentences, the things that attribute to the self-confidence issues that maybe you are dealing with even now. So my three of my sentences, Christy, the last girl who looked for love in all of the wrong places. That was me for a very long time and is still sometimes today. Christy, the approval-seeking girl who people pleased until she made herself sick. And I will tell you right now, that's something I still struggle with to this day. I'm a people-pleaser, crazy person. Christy, the meek girl who was terrified to be herself. So she blended in, never spoke up. And that is something that I'm gaining more confidence in and I'm working through. I feel better about today, but it's something that's been an ongoing battle for me my whole life. And I always just wanted to follow, never wanted to lead. So as I've shared with you guys, doing calls like this, leading our team is so terrifying to me and something that I feel incredibly weak at and that I need to spend a lot of time working on. So whatever it is for you, whatever the things are that you've identified yourself as in the past or that you're currently struggling with and identifying yourself as, I want to challenge you to write those out, whether it be now, tonight, throughout the week. Think through that for you. We're going to go on to the next slide here. I want you to think about who God says that you are, the true identity that you have. And I want you guys to write these things down for the times that you need to hear this over and over and over again like I do. Christy, the forgiven child of God, and there's scripture references to go with it if you want to spend time looking those up. If you're ever dealing with any of these things, these areas that you need some help and some guidance in. So Christy, I am a forgiven child of God. Say these things for yourself. Christy, the set free child of God. Christy, the accepted child of God. Christy, the holy child of God. Christy, the made new child of God. Christy, the loved child of God. Christy, the close child of God. Christy, the confident child of God. And Christy, the victorious child of God. Just hearing those things, saying them out loud, is so empowering. It just feels so good to say those things and to know that that is the truth. Those things are true about me, not the things back there that I've dealt with or that I struggle with or that I go through. Those things don't identify me. Those are issues that I personally struggle through. But I already know that this is my true identity here. This is the truth. These are the things that God has said that I am. And any of those times that my go-to scripts tell me otherwise, I know that there's something going on that shouldn't be going on. And reminding myself of these truths is so uplifting and so empowering. So I challenge you guys to keep these things handy. If you have a work area, like my desk area, post it on a piece of paper, make a poster, put it on a whiteboard, put it on sticky notes. With some of the times where my mind starts wandering and I start thinking about business stuff and then getting anxious, sounds so silly, but like when I'm getting ready in the morning, it's actually a quiet time, right? Where I should be like praying and thinking and peacefully filling my mind with positive things. A lot of times my mind starts thinking about my business and I start feeling overwhelmed and anxious and thinking of all that I have to do. And so I want to personally make sticky notes and put these around my bathroom mirror so that I see them when I'm getting ready in the morning. Whatever areas that you're in when you know that your mind tends to go to that place, write down these kinds of statements and help your mind to start. Whenever you think those negative thoughts or those self-sabotaging thoughts, those whatever they are for you, thoughts, the ones that derail you, and take you away from the truth, I want you to start filling your mind with these kinds of true statements. So write them down, post them, wherever works for you. Okay, we were made to be set free, holy, new, loved, and confident. That's the way that we were made. I'd say that that means that we are more. We can't allow ourselves to partake in anything that negates from our true identity. So whether it's those excuses, rationalizations, escape clauses, things like, oh, I'll get to it later, I'll do it later. We always say those kinds of things, right? Our negative self-talk, our lack of confidence, whatever it is for you, fill in the blank. We can't allow those things. We can't allow ourselves to partake in any of those things that negate from our true identity, because it is a slow downhill thing. And we are made to be, you know, up here on that level that God says that we are. So we must remember that we were made for more, because we have, personally as coaches, we have so many people that need to be reminded of that. Okay, I know for me, my challenge groups are an opportunity for me to speak that truth into the lives of the people that allow me to work with them. And yes, I am teaching them about healthy living. Yes, I am teaching them how to be persistent and consistent in their working out and making their lives more positive that way. But I know that my greatest purpose, personally, within our team, within my challenge groups, is to remind all of the women that I work with and the few men that we are more than all of those things that get in our minds and set us back. And so we have to remember that ourselves, so that we can teach that too and inspire people that want to work with us to remember that themselves. So it's something that is very, very important, and that I hope that you guys will take time on a daily basis to include into your essentials before you begin any of your work for the day within your business. So that is the message for tonight. Next time on May 12th, we will be diving into the next part that she breaks down through that scripture. It's called Finding the Deeper Reason. And, you know, that's something that connects with all of us really well, right? We very much focus on the why within people's health journeys and the why within our businesses. But I want to really talk to you guys about that from a spiritual perspective as well, how we can include that as a part of our journey too. So Finding the Deeper Reason, we will be diving into that on May 12th. And that is all I have for you guys tonight. I am going to, like I always do, I'm going to go ahead and end the call now, so the recording will cut off. And then I will hop back on for anybody that has questions. You want to hop back on, just click that same link. I will be back on and available to help you guys. I will say probably another 15 minutes. So if you have anything for me, I will be on and available for another 15 minutes, okay? Thank you guys for hopping on. I look forward to continuing with you on May 12th, and of course, meeting with you guys, talking with you guys much more between then, okay? All right, thanks guys. I will see you next time.